Hi, I'm Yev.
And I'm James.
And we're here with another episode of Stocks and Storage. Today, we're talking about guidance. Now, there's a lot of different types of guidance out there. There's spiritual guidance.
There's educational guidance.
There's navigational guidance.
Guidance counselors.
There's also religious guidance.
Yes.
And financial guidance, which is what we're here talking about today. Right. So what is guidance?
Yeah, so in the context of a public company like Backblaze, who you know went public back in November of last year, guidance is when a company helps investors understand what the financial outlook for the company looks like. So because you know we're a lot closer to our business than investors are, we like to help them understand, okay, not just the results that we just reported, but also you know what do the results look like, say, over the next quarter or, say, over the course of the entire year. Backblaze gives guidance on a quarterly and annual basis. So it's not required, but because we're closer to the business, it helps investors understand, you know, what we think the business will look like in the coming time periods.
Nice. So it's like an educated guess. And because we are very well educated in our business, or at least that's the hope, right? Since we're the ones that run it, it's basically telling the market like, hey, we think this is going to happen over the next couple months or over the next year.
Right.
Nice. And for in Backblaze's case, we have a recurring revenue business that's relatively solid. We have some, you know, additional contracts and stuff, but we're able to make that guidance a lot smoother because of the recurring revenue. Is that right?
Yeah. So I mean, software is a great business because people tend to continue buying it once they start. Mm-hmm. Of course, you know, you work on the backup business where we have some 1 year and 2 year contracts, so that's pretty predictable. And you know, nothing certain in life, but you know, certainly, you know, a business like ours is less volatile than say like a, you know, a car business or a computer business where you really just don't know how many units you're going to sell in a given quarter. That's going to drive your revenue. So, end of the day, yeah, software is a lot more predictable because it's recurring, and that helps us give more reliable guidance potentially.
Nice. And I have been told that the thing you want least in your investments is volatility. For the
most
part. I
think that's fair. Yes.
Okay. Well, thank you, James, for that guide to guidance. We'll see everyone else on the next episode of
Stocks and Storage.
Yes, I can speak a little bit or a lot.
James.
Luke, I am your father.
Say hi to your mother for me.
Oh, God. He almost made it through.